Hey guys, it's Katie here with Visualicity. Today we're going to be talking about X theme extensions. Since there are quite a lot of them, we're not going to go over everything, just doing a quick brief intro. So I'm here, I'm really excited about it. Stella here is kind of excited, I guess, but you should be excited. We're going to send you over to Nick. Okay. Stella! It was great! All right, so we're going to send you over to Nick, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Please subscribe if you like our videos, and have a great day.
We're starting off with my favorite Xtheme plugin, Cornerstone. This plugin was created by the creators of Xtheme, and it replaces Visual Composer. Everything's built section by section, and it's a visual editor. This way, you're able to see exactly what your website will look like while you build it. Cornerstone comes with over 40 page building elements. The elements usually look really good when you drop them on the page, but they also let you customize pretty much every aspect of them through the interface. You're also able to add custom CSS or even animate the elements with Cornerstone's built-in animation features. Using these elements in combination with each other should pretty much satisfy any page building need you will ever have. Cornerstone also allows you to save and upload templates. We have a more in-depth video on this, so a link should be popping up right about now for that. If you click on the little phone button on the bottom of the editor, it'll bring up the five common sizes for various devices people might be viewing your site with. This allows you to easily optimize for mobile or practically any other device with Cornerstone. My favorite feature in Cornerstone is the ability to enter custom CSS or JavaScript to pages individually. You don't even need to use the customizer anymore because of this thing. That saves you so much time switching between customizer and page builder. Also, every piece of CSS that you add to the page will only affect that individual page. Surprisingly, the Xtheme plugin that I use the second most is the under construction plugin. It's easy to set up with just a click of the button, and you're able to customize a lot of stuff. Everything from Facebook profiles, headings, to background images. You're even able to insert a little timer that lets your viewers know when the maintenance is going to be completed by. This is a nice touch plugin that'll add a little flair to your website when you're doing maintenance. Okay, onto Essential Grid. This one is awesome. It's extensive. We won't be able to cover nearly all of it in this video. I mean, it really creates beautiful grids for all purposes. Videos, pictures, blogs, ads, you name it, anything you can put in here. They look great. Like many of X's plugins, this one comes with a built-in visual editor. You're really able to put in a lot of your own customizations here, allowing you to create something truly unique. Editor also comes with customizable icons and text boxes that you can use to build your grid. You're even able to enter custom CSS, as well as save as you go. If you click right here, it brings up Essential Grid's 30 customizable skin presets. You're able to edit, favorite, duplicate, delete, or even create your own. This is our go-to plugin for creating blogs or just featuring content. Essential Grid is also integrated into Cornerstone, so you can easily place it on pages whenever you want to. This also allows you to disable Essential Grid for devices that may not be able to load the plugin very well. Alright, onto a much less complicated plugin, Custom 404. This is a nice touch plugin that's really easily activated, allowing you to replace your 404 page with any page on your site. Here are some examples, like a search bar, or you can do a funny monster guy. This is just a nice way to add a unique touch to your site. Xtheme ships with three different slider plugins, and they all have their strengths and weaknesses. Each one comes with a built-in visual editor, which is pretty nice. We're starting off with Revolution Slider here, which I believe is the most extensive one, but also the heaviest. Revolution sacrifices a lot of page speed, oftentimes adding 5 seconds to a site's loading time. That said, the trade-off is you have the most beautiful slider that I can find for WordPress. Revolution is the best slider I've found for having videos on the top of your homepage, which, although it does catch people's eye, it slows everything down. Layer Slider's in the middle of the road. It's quicker to load than Revolution, while still having the fancy features and effects. Its visual editor isn't too shabby either. Using this slider is the best way to get the fancy parts of Revolution without getting the page speed slowdowns. It's not quite as fast as Soliloquy, but in my opinion it has a much more advanced and easy to use editor. Soliloquy's editor isn't quite as visual as the other ones, but it still has a lot of options and manages to be lightning fast compared to the other slider plugins. According to the developer, every aspect of Soliloquy was built with optimization in mind. The slider may be a little bit more basic than the other ones, but when you really test the speeds, this one always comes out on top and still has a lot of features. I don't always recommend using a slider, but Xtheme definitely covers all the bases with its slider plugins. You can really tell ThemeCo is trying to make an all-in-one theme. They even included a Terms of Use plugin. This one's really easy to use. Just click the button, pick the page you want to use for your Terms of Use, update, and boom. A checkbox and a Terms of Use hyperlink has been created, and if people don't check that box, then they get this error message. Since we're on the topic of login page customization, it's a good time to bring up White Label. This plugin allows you to replace the WordPress logo with your own or a client's logo when logging in. It also allows you to customize the X dashboard homepage so you can leave yourself a reminder or give a client who you're turning the website over to some valuable information. You're only able to use this small list of HTML tags on the page, but it's enough to make something interesting. Now I know I say this a lot, but Smooth Scroll is another nice touch plugin, easily activated with the click of a button. This one is actually really hard to display with video because the effect it has is mostly on the scroll wheel. This plugin should really only be used in certain cases. The best example I've seen is for displaying photographers' pictures. This is just footage of one of Xtheme's demos with scroll wheel enabled on it. There's never a shortage of photographers looking to display their work online. If you show them something like this, they're going to be sold immediately. Since we're on the topic of photo display, I want to talk about Enviro Gallery. Or is it Envira Gallery? I don't know. Either way, living up to the other plugin's expectations, this one also has its built-in visual editor allowing you to build your slideshows exactly how you'd like them. It also comes with all sorts of customizations as well as the ability to customize for mobile. This is just some footage of Envira's demo page. Your images or videos are displayed in lightbox fashion. You can scroll through the photos with the arrows on top or with the thumbnails on the bottom. The plugin also allows you to place social sharing icons on the front of your pictures, which I personally find annoying, but I guess it's good from a marketing standpoint. Like I mentioned earlier, you can also put videos in the slideshow if you want. I might use this actually. I don't know, we'll see. Oh, and you can also put watermarks or put passwords on your photos too, which is pretty slick. At the time of recording, ConvertPlug is the newest Xtheme plugin, and it's also unique in that it is exclusive to Xtheme. To put it simply, ConvertPlug is an all-in-one marketing tool. Its purpose is simple, and that is to get users who visit your site to do what you want them to do. You do this by attaching your promotions to ConvertPlug's built-in modules. We're going to start with Modal Pop-Up. Just the way I like it, it comes with a bunch of pre-built templates so you can customize to your heart's content. These templates were obviously built with ConvertPlug's purpose in mind. With that being said, I think Modal Pop-Up is a little bit intrusive, so we're going to talk about the info bar. This just displays a discrete info bar on the top of the screen. This is really useful for driving traffic or building email lists. ConvertPlug also has its own built-in visual editor, which allows you to easily customize the templates that it comes with. This what you see is what you get editor allows you to change pretty much everything about your pop-ups. It's really easy to use too, it kind of reminds me of Cornerstone. Except Cornerstone doesn't have all these built-in animated effects, look at all these. You can also enter your own custom CSS, so you can pretty much do anything with ConvertPlug if you want to. With this little button right here, you're able to easily view what your website or your module would look like on various devices. These are all just the standard sizes, and it makes the design process a lot easier. I have to say the best part of ConvertPlug, though, is this custom CSS class feature, which all you have to do is enter your own custom CSS name, save, and you're able to use it in Cornerstone for pretty much any element you want to, too. All you have to do is enter it in the class section, and a Cornerstone element of your choice will have ConvertPlug integrated with it. Pretty slick. You're also able to integrate the mail lists that you build with Mailchimp through this interface. Once again, we didn't even come close to finishing it all, so look forward to a future video on us going more in-depth in ConvertPlug as well. Since we're on the subject of Mailchimp, now's a good time to cover it. This is the go-to plugin for managing your mail lists. It's got this built-in analytics tool which allows you to view your monthly mail list growth, which is pretty awesome. Also, if you wanted to, you can manually change your subscriber list with this button right here. Mailchimp also helps you with your mailing campaigns by providing templates. They have these blank columnized templates that you can edit yourself. They also have pre-made templates designed to fit various purposes you might have with your mailing campaigns. I'm just going to click this one right here so we can see what this looks like. Mailchimp has elements similar to Cornerstone that you can just click and drag into the page. Everything updates live, which is pretty sweet. They've created a visual editor inside of an email campaign creator, and there's actually quite a lot of design elements you can use. There's also the ability to view these in preview mode and see what they look like on a mobile device. A lot of people do check their mail on their phone, so it makes sense. You can save all your customizations as you go, so this really makes everything easy with Mailchimp. It's relatively simple to use Google Analytics with Xtheme. It's easy because there's only two options, header and footer. If you place the plugin in your header, it'll only track visits to the very top of your site. If it's placed in the footer, it'll only track visits that have waited for the entire page to load. My guess is this is Analytics' attempt at keeping bots from being tracked. Analytics is easily set up with the Analytics code obtained from the Google Analytics website. Now time to talk about a more aesthetical plugin, Typekit. This plugin gives you access to Adobe's entire library of fonts. You just have to click the link right here, and then it'll bring you to the Adobe sign-up page where you have to create an account. Once you're signed in, you go in and create a new kit for your website. The plugin does all the heavy lifting, so you don't have to enter any of this code. You just browse all the fonts from there. You have access to over 1,200 font families with this plugin. There's also options for advanced customizations on the sidebar on the right. There's a ton of really good fonts in here. I'm just going to pick Fat Frank. There's even more options for customization, but I'm just going to add this to my existing kit. Once you've got it added, you're able to view all your kits and make final changes. Just press publish when you're ready, and then go to view all your kits to get your kit ID. All you have to do is copy that kit ID, bring it over to your plugin interface, type it in, press update, and you've got access to your chosen fonts. This is a really simple way to customize your site. At the time of recording, there's two comment plugins for Xtheme, Facebook and Discuss Comments. We're going to start off with Discuss Comments. You set it up with a short name generated by Discuss's website. Before you're able to get the short name, you have to sign up. Once you've done so, just click WordPress, grab this code from down here, copy it, and paste it into the plugin interface. This is another one of X's really simple setup plugins, and it gives you a little bit more of a community feel in your comments section than the normal WordPress comments. Users are able to follow each other as well as set up profile pictures and recommend articles as well as see who's following them. This plugin promotes user engagement on your site, which will keep people coming back. Every return visitor is a win in my opinion. The other X comment plugin option is Facebook Comments. It requires similar setup, you just have to get App ID and App Secret from their Facebook Developers Portal. It also requires a registration, so go through that, select Website. Then click Create App ID, enter your information, pick the lines or whatever test you have to do, copy your App ID, head over to the plugin interface, enter that, and then you have to copy the App Secret as well. I leave mine not shown just for security purposes, but you have to press Show before you copy it, otherwise it won't work. Alright, so I just paste it in and press update, and then Facebook Comments is on my page. It seems like people trust Facebook a little bit more than Discuss Comments, so maybe they're more likely to sign up and post with this. It also keeps users who aren't logged in from posting on your page, so this is a good way to prevent spam. Thank you for making it this far. This is my last plugin, Video Lock. This one basically just allows you to do things with videos that you haven't been able to do with WordPress before. You can add buttons as well as put in headings that are able to be seen with search engine bots. There's all sorts of interesting tweaks you can make inside the plugin interface. I encourage you to peek through it yourself. All in all, Video Lock is a useful and underrated marketing tool. So, there are a few plugins that I don't cover in this video. One of them is Content Doc. I don't cover this one because I think Convert Plug completely replaces it. Another one would be Olark, and I didn't cover this one because I checked out the page and it hasn't been updated in 3 years. If you want, I can go into more detail on this in a future video, but for now I'm leaving it. Lastly, I'm not covering Visual Composer because honestly, Cornerstone completely replaces it in my opinion. Sorry if other people don't agree with that, but that's just my preference. I just want to give a huge thank you to everybody who made it this far in the video and put up with me this long. I had a lot of fun making this video. Thank you for watching. Please give it a thumbs up if you liked it. We've got a lot of videos in the making going really in depth with these plugins, so please subscribe to be notified as soon as those come out. Really excited to show you guys some of the stuff that we've learned. Thanks again for watching. This is Nick signing out.